Good day and welcome to Space Station Live for Wednesday, August 7th, 2013. The Expedition 36 crew has been involved in a variety of experiments today and research activities, including one called the ACE experiment, the Advanced Colloids experiment, the first in a series of microscopic imaging investigations of materials to determine how better to formulate materials in the microgravity environment of space. Astronaut Karen Nyberg, her gloved hands inside the microgravity science glove box earlier today, had an opportunity to prepare for the next run of data collection with the Advanced Colloids experiment, again in the microgravity science glove box in the Destiny Laboratory of the International Space Station, just one of a variety of experiments being conducted on board the International Space Station. Meanwhile, Russian cosmonauts Fyodor Yurchikhin and Alexander Mazurkin were busy in the Russian segment of the complex preparing their Orlan spacesuits for two spacewalks coming up on August 16th and August 22nd. The first of those two spacewalks to be conducted outside of the Pier's docking compartment by Yurchikhin and Mazurkin will install a panel of experiments on the Poisk module, deploy a gap spanner between the Zarya module and Poisk, and to install Ethernet cables on the Poisk module that will be part of the hardware associated with the arrival of a new Russian laboratory module at the end of the year. 6 days later, they'll venture back outside the Pier's docking compartment on August 22nd for another spacewalk in which they will trade out a laser experiment on the outside of the Russian segment of the space station for a pointing platform upon which an optical telescope will be launched in the near future. The Japanese cargo ship, the H-2 Transfer Vehicle, or the HTV-4, continues to fly smoothly toward the International Space Station, having conducted a series of rendezvous maneuvers again throughout the past 24 hours. As of a few minutes ago, the HTV was traveling just under 5,000 statute miles behind the International Space Station, some 70 statute miles below the complex, phasing back toward the International Space Station at a rate of about 770 statute miles per orbit. The HTV is poised to be captured by astronauts Karen Nyberg and Chris Cassidy using the station's robotic arm on Friday morning, the capture scheduled at 6:29 a.m. Central Time. Cassidy and Nyberg are also working inside the Japanese Kibo module, preparing a series of satellites called SPHERES, the acronym for the Synchronized Position Hold Engage Reorient and Experimental Satellites, for some test runs that will be conducted in an ongoing competition with students that will be gathered next Tuesday at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, where the experiment's principal investigators are housed. The SPHERES experiments enable students to engage in a competition in which they program the satellites to gather data on the operation of free-flying satellites in a microgravity environment. And that's a glimpse of what's taking place today aboard the International Space Station.